Now, in a crash that even shocked first responders.
Two people died on Interstate 29 today near Percival, and five others were hurt after the family's SUV rolled through the median.
KETV Newswatch 7's Hannah Pickett joins us live with the latest. Hannah.
Rob, the family lives in Smyrna, Tennessee. The youngest victim, a 7-month-old baby girl. She's at the Nebraska Medical Center right now, along with four other survivors. A 15-year-old did not survive, neither did a 24-year-old woman. A scene like this will stick with just about anyone.
And you never forget the traumatic ones. You know, it stays with you. You learn from it.
First responders like Captain Dustin Sheldon with Sydney's Volunteer Fire Department are no exception.
This is probably one of the worst ones we've had in probably the last 10 years as far as shock value goes.
Sheldon and 12 other volunteers from Sydney were some of the first on scene to this Interstate 29 crash near Percival, Iowa, Sunday morning.
Our rescue scene was very long. I mean, we had probably a quarter-mile rescue scene there.
The Iowa State Patrol says this SUV from Tennessee lost control and rolled into the median. Two of its passengers ejected, a 15-year-old and 24-year-old woman killed on impact, one of them hit by a semi, five others taken by air or ambulance to the hospital.
Everybody in that vehicle that was in it could have died very easily.
A tough scene to stomach for a responder like Sheldon, who's seen stuff like this for 17 years.
We had a teenager that died. That's always tough when you're dealing with kids.
The State Patrol says only two of the passengers were wearing seat belts, and first responders say that should send a message.
Wear seat belts. Seat belts save lives. That's why the signs are up. That's why we're supposed to do it.
Now, the Iowa State Patrol says the victims who died, Maria and Alex Ledesma, were not wearing seatbelts. We do know Ricardo Azario Torres is in fair condition. The hospital is not releasing the conditions of the other survivors. As for those first responders from Sydney, they'll likely have a meeting in the next 48 hours to help deal with the stress of what they saw. Reporting live, Hannah Pickett, KETV Newswatch 7.
Thanks.